Respond in chat. A 1936 New York Times review called the debut novel by this author, in all probability, the biggest book of the year. 1,037 pages. Write down your responses now.
Bressler, how about now? Let's do this, folks! Johnny Gilbert says...
This is Jeopardy! Here are today's contestants.
A cashier from Clifton Park, New Jersey, Chris Palmer. An office technician from Los Angeles, California, Lisa Adams. And a barista and student from Rochester, New York, Sheldon Lewis II. And now, here is the host of Jeopardy, me. Hi, everybody. Welcome to Jep Squad. Thank you so much for tuning in. This has been developed. Hey, Christian Dixie, thank you for the follow. Thanks for messing up my intro, too. Thank you to everybody who's been following in the last few minutes. This is one hell of a treat that I hope you guys are going to enjoy every week. You know, I've been working on this for about a little more than a month now, and thanks to the guys of the DFIU network. Hey, Dev now follows. Thank you, Dev. So thanks to the people at the DFIU network that have inspired me to get a Stream Deck, and I wanted to do something that I feel like would challenge me in a bit, and that was, of course, the doing Jeopardy. So we've got three amazing people that want to play. Now I want to put something. Really important, really quick. We have a fundraiser, if you can see on the bottom of the screen right there. For the rest of 2021, we are raising money for the Muscular Dystrophy Association in honor of my good friend Tommy Reyes, who we lost earlier last month, just 25 years old. I mean, he was just the happiest kid in the world, had everything going for him. And, you know, we want to do something really, really nice for him. So we're hopefully we can reach our goal of $5,000 by the end of 2021. And you don't have to donate, but it would be a very nice gesture. So, Sheldon, Lisa, Chris, you've been waiting here for about a good half an hour at this point. You guys ready to play?
Let's get this.
All right, everybody, let's go to work. All right, let's take a look at our categories today, and they are My Son, the Doctor, followed by Sports Superstars, European History, and we'll enter the realm of YouTube, and we'll take a look at the Book of Guinness World Records, and finally, Seven Letter Cars. Very interesting stuff so far. We tossed coin, and Sheldon, you have the first selection, so... let's play.
All right, let's go. Guinness World Records for two, please.
She holds the record for the longest career as a TV judge. Sheldon.
Who is Judge Judith Scheinlin?
Yes, Judge Judy for short. Go again.
400 Guinness.
In 2014, 17-year-old Malala Yousafzai became the youngest winner of this award. Lisa.
Nobel Peace Prize.
Say it again.
What is the Nobel Peace Prize?
Thank you. You cut off for a second. You're good.
Guinness World Records for 600, please.
A 101-year-old became the world's oldest conductor when he led the Pensacola Civic Band in this state. Chris.
What is Florida?
Very good. Now everybody's on the board.
Guinness 800.
Answer. A Dominican Republic bar set a record with a glass holding nearly 1,000 gallons of this rum, lime, and mint drink. Sheldon.
What is a mojito?
Exactly. You brew coffee, so I would think, you know, this wouldn't be any different.
let's finish off Guinness, please.
Answer. The oldest sweet shop in England is in this historic county where Downton Abbey is set. And that would be Yorkshire. Okay, Sheldon, we're done with that category. Let's go somewhere else.
Seven Letter Cars, too.
Love it or loathe it. In 2000, Chrysler introduced the PT. Chris.
What is Cruiser?
Yes, the PT Cruiser.
Seven Letter Cars, 400.
This Ford pony car debuted in 1964. Sheldon.
What is the Mustang?
Correct.
600 cars.
A 1947 race car was the first car built by this Italian luxury automaker that's now worth over $20 billion. Sheldon again.
What is Ferrari?
Ferrari is right.
800 cars.
In the 90s, Porsche introduced this model as an answer to Mazda's Miata. Chris.
What is the Carrera?
No. We were looking for the Boxster. Sheldon,
Right again. Let's finish that one off, too.
Jeep makes this compact SUV with the same name as a navigational instrument. Sheldon.
What is the compass?
Exactly.
European 200.
The hiding place where she wrote her diary during World War II is now an Amsterdam museum. Sheldon.
Who is Frank?
Anne Frank, right.
400 European.
Born in 1769, this world leader was actually about 5'6", around average height for a Frenchman of his day. Sheldon.
Who is Napoleon Bonaparte?
Right.
600 European.
Answer. Maria Montessori was the first woman from this country to receive a medical degree. Chris.
What is Italy?
Italy is right.
Sports Superstars 200, please.
In 1980, at age 19, this great one of the NHL won the first of his 9 MVP awards. Chris.
Who is Wayne Gretzky?
Correct.
400 sports superstars.
In a 2015 game against the Giants, this Saints quarterback threw 7 touchdown passes. Chris.
Who is Drew Brees?
That's right, and that's going to take you up to 1,200. Lisa has 400. Sheldon has 3,600. We're going to take a short break. Now, before we do that, we have a special word from our friends over at Sesame Street. We'll be right back.
I'll be seeing you in all of our favorite places with laughter and warm embraces all day through. The park where we play the stoop across the way, that favorite cookie smell and Big Bird's tree we love so well. I'll be seeing you
with free COVID-19 vaccines. Sunnier days are ahead. Visit getvaccineanswers.org.
I'll be seeing you.
It's been difficult because I hadn't been able to see my grandchildren.
An expression on someone's face when you do something nice for them.
I miss all my friends in school.
Visit getvaccineanswers.org so you can make an informed decision about COVID-19 vaccine.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for once again joining us here on JEP Squad. And right now, let's take the time to meet our players. So we're starting off with Chris Palmer, a cashier from Clifton Park, New Jersey. Now, it says here that you auditioned for Jeopardy, and apparently the date has been cursed?
Well, here's what happened. It was June 25th, 2009. And I think it was cursed because unfortunately that happened to be the day that both Farrah Fawcett and Michael Jackson died.
Oh, because so, I thought it was like, oh, it was a Friday the 13th or something, but I did not know that.
It was a hot day, middle of the week, and as a matter of fact, as I was coming home from New York for the audition, that's when I found out about Michael Jackson. I heard about Farrah Fawcett earlier in the day, and I felt like, okay, maybe this isn't a good sign. And as it turned out, I didn't get picked. So.
You know, the year was just horrible. I mean, we lost so many great people. Billy Mays, Ed McMahon. I mean, so many amazing people we lost.
I know.
And also, it says that you almost trucked a former Jeopardy contestant at a convention. What happened?
Okay, huh? All right. I may be exaggerating this a little bit, but I think a few years back, I went out to the big trivia gathering in Las Vegas first time I was out there, and this was during the game show throwdown. I'm leaving the hallway, and all of a sudden they see Pam Mueller. With those who are in the know, she was a former Jeopardy college champ from years ago. Mm. And she is a tiny, tiny little woman, I gotta say.
Yes.
If you saw my picture, you saw how big I am. If I had come by like 1 second earlier, I would have probably sent her flying across the room. Caused some serious damage. So.
Thank God you didn't. Otherwise, she probably wouldn't. Now, was this before like the All-Star Games or was this after? I don't know.
I think this probably, well, this was 2018, so I think it was like the year after they did that.
Okay,
so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Best of luck to you. All right, Lisa Adams, an office technician from Los Angeles, California. Tell me about true crime, because it says here that you watch a lot of true crime. What is it about?
I am fortunately or unfortunately obsessed with Dateline and all those types of shows. Investigation, Discovery, and those types of channels are my friends.
Jeez. So it's like,
would you like want to have like a if you ever had a like got to meet Chris Hansen, would you want him to go, Lisa, have a seat?
No, I think that would be super. I would be more interested in meeting Keith Morrison than Chris Hansen. Just saying.
Good. And it also says here that you are a fan of wrestling. Is there any sort of wrestling you enjoy? AEW, WWE, or is it just all around?
I'm a recent wrestling fan. Just started probably about Royal Rumble of this year, so January. WWE for me, Raw and SmackDown at this point. I haven't tried AEW or NXT yet.
Oh wow! Well, hopefully you get back on the buzzer soon. Hopefully you knock it out, if you know what I mean. Sheldon Lewis II, a barista and student from Rochester, New York. Where do you go to school?
I go to the Rochester Institute of Technology.
Woo-woo! And are you a junior, senior?
That is a complicated situation, because RIT has a five-year program, but those 5 years are contingent on a co-op. It's split 6 months, one way, 6 months another way. And I'm having a little bit of trouble on that search. So it's going a little bit longer than I'd like to, but it's definitely been fulfilling nonetheless.
Yikes. Well, if you saw in the intro, you might have seen that Sheldon had a photo with Alex Trebek. You were a Jeopardy college quarterfinalist. That's right. Quarterfinalist. You didn't make it that far, but hey, you got to be on Jeopardy.
Did, and meeting Alex was amazing. I will always have that memory. I will always have that as well, to hold over people that wanted to criticize my performance on the show, which is fun, because a lot of contestants will talk to you and they'll let you know, oh no, I watched your game, you played a good game, no matter what. But it's always the people that have never touched the game, never went through all of the bumps and the hurdles, that want to be armchair detectives, and it's really great to look at them and go, okay, I get you saw me not do so well on television, but let's ask, who was on television?
Exactly. That's what people need to realize. You know, the fact that you were able to get on the show means that you were smart to begin with. So tell me about Shell Mom.
So I am the friend that watches over my friends in the group. And a lot of my tendencies aren't, you know, the stand back and just watch people. Dad, it's the very hands-on mom. And plus, on top of that, I was a mama's boy for all of my life. And so my friends just started calling me Shell Mom one day, and it really stuck. And I respond to it no matter what. I think it's really cute. I like the nickname, and it fits me.
You know what? Hang on. I'm going to fix something real quick. Let me just...
He's not going to do it.
I'm going to do it.
Oh, I'm going to get Lord. Oh.
Ta-da! Wait. Is it going to do it? There it is. Ta-da!
There it is.
All right, let's get back into this game. Chris, you have control of the board, so where would you like to continue?
Let's go to my son, the doctor, for 200.
All right, answer is, my Steven is such a nice boy, but I wish they'd call him Sorcerer Supreme instead of this Marvel name. Sheldon.
Who is Doctor Strange?
Correct.
European 8.
Answer is, speaking in West Berlin, Ronald Reagan aimed his tear down this wall's demand at this leader. Shomom.
Who is Gorbachev?
Correct.
I see, I told you, I roll with it. 1,000 European.
Reigning until 1901, this British queen was the last from the House of Hanover. Chris.
Who is Victoria?
Correct.
YouTube 200.
Jimmy Fallon got 7 million views for his shot-by-shot remake of You Spin Me Round with this Ant-Man star. Lisa.
Who is Paul Rudd?
Correct.
YouTube for 400, please.
I never move my lips when I do this kind of comedy act that earned Jeff Dunham millions of views. Chris.
What is ventriloquism?
Correct.
YouTube 600.
Answer, Daily Double. All right, so you have 2,600. You're just 2,000 shy of Shell Mom's lead. How much would you like to risk?
1,400, please.
1,400 for this clue. Best of luck. Fans debated the symbolism in this rapper's 2018 video, This Is America.
Who is Kanye West?
No. Childish Gambino, otherwise known, or Donald Glover. That's all right. You're down to 1,200, but you still have control.
YouTube 8.
Millions saw Mozart and Skrillex locked in an epic one of these battles of history. Chris.
What is a rap battle?
Correct. Yep, epic rap battles of history.
And finish it.
At the 2018 Teen Choice Awards, the award for Choice YouTuber went to this Double Dare host. Sheldon.
Who is Koshy?
Liza Koshy, indeed.
400 Doctor.
We presume you know Dr. Livingstone, Neil and Agnes's boy, was found by Henry Stanley in 1871 on this continent. Chris.
What is Africa?
Africa, right.
My son the doctor for 600.
My boy is a nephrologist, a doctor who diagnoses and treats diseases of these organs. Sheldon.
What are the kidneys?
Kidneys, right.
800 Doctor.
My son is this oath namesake and father of modern medicine, so I call myself grandfather of modern medicine. Sheldon.
It's Hippocrates.
Hippocrates, right. Everybody keeps violating that, or violating, according to a lot of anti-maskers, the HIPAA Act, which is not even real. Okay, Sheldon, go again.
Oh, I feel that one. 1,000 Doctor.
I'm proud of his 76 ABA dunk contest win, but it's his 81 NBA MVP with the 76ers I can't help but brag about. Chris.
Who is Dr. J, Julius Irving?
Wow, you got both of them in, so yes. Go again.
Superstars or six.
Four winners of the Indy 500 Rookie of the Year Award, Mario, Michael, Jeff, and Marco, are members of this family. Lisa.
Who is Andretti?
Right.
800, please.
The first female UFC champion. She also won a 2008 Olympic medal in judo. Chris.
Who is Ronda Rousey?
Right, and the last clue. In 1997, this baseball pioneer became the first to have his number retired. Why is that clue still... Hang on a moment. Why is that clue still up there? This is fun, folks. We have our first technical difficulty of the game.
Yeah. Flashing pink.
It's flashing. There we go.
There we go.
Let's get rid of that. All right. And let's deal with this. Are you still having issues?
I'm fine. It's
still on the main screen for me.
Which is weird. It shouldn't be. Thank you, Google. Yeah, Dev says I blame Google.
Blame everything on Google.
It's all Google's fault. Oh, wait.
It's all Google's fault.
Or Amazon, one of the two.
Oh, boy. So, I'm just going to read the last clue. Okay. In 1997... this baseball pioneer became the first to have his number retired by every pro team in a sport. Chris.
Who is Jackie Robbins?
There we go. And with that, you go to 5,200. Lisa's in third place with 1,200. Sheldon has 7,000. So, Lisa, you're going to start in double jeopardy. When we come back from this, we'll be right back.
It's been difficult because I hadn't been able to see my grandchildren.
I'll be seeing you in all the old familiar places.
So I thought a lot about what I miss the most during this pandemic. And the thing that I miss the most is you.
I love playing to a live audience. There's nothing like it.
There's nothing like feeling the love that you guys give to us, and we're trying to give to you, and I just can't wait to get back to that.
All these places that we stand in, the Ryman, Opry House, those places are just places if you don't put the people in them.
The COVID-19 vaccines are going to help us all get back to the moments we miss.
It's totally normal to have questions. I did too. That's why it's so important to get informed.
There's a lot of talk out there about the vaccines. So ask your doctor and get the facts. It's up to you.
COVID-19 has changed how we stomp the yard and feel the beat. How we stroll. How we step. How we show our pride. Now it's time to take the first step that lets us get back to strolling instead of scrolling. Before we can safely come together, we need the facts. As COVID-19 vaccines become available, you may have questions.
Is it safe?
Should I get it?
Is it free?
It's okay to have questions. Now get the facts about COVID-19 vaccines at getvaccineanswers.org so you can make an informed decision for yourself and for your family.
All right. Well, I think we fixed our little issues. So, Dev, thank you for the tips. Whew, interesting start to our stream and our streaming career, as we would say. As we mentioned before, Sheldon's in the lead with 7,000. We have Chris with 5,200. Lisa, you'll get to go first in Double Jeopardy with these categories. Then they are helpful holiday hints, movie stars. V is for veterans. Notice the V in quotation marks. Ages. It's a collection. And finally, I think you'll like this one, everybody. Boy bands. All righty, then. We're going to start off with Lisa. You have control of the board.
What to choose? What to choose? Let's go with boy bands for 400, please.
The answer is... Every spring, you can count on seeing the It's Gonna Be Me meme based on a song by this group. Chris.
What is NSYNC?
NSYNC is right. What you got against NSYNC?
I got nothing against NSYNC. I have a meme, though.
You're looking at an NSYNC stan over here, by the way. All right, go again.
It's terror
when I'm with you.
800,
you said?
Yeah.
Okay. In 1996, they sang Quit Playing Games with My Heart. In 2018, they released Don't Go Breaking My Heart. Lisa.
Backstreet Boys.
The Backstreet Boys. I don't hate them, but we're supposed to be rivals. Okay. Go again, Lisa.
It's like Star Trek and Star Wars. Moving on. I'll take boy bands for 1,200, please.
Although they lost on the British version of The X Factor, One Direction got a record contract from this judge. Lisa.
Who is Simon Cowell?
Correct.
Let's continue boy bands for 1,600, please.
He's the oldest Jonas brother. Oh, go back to the board, please. Who's Kevin Jonas?
Oh.
Joe's in the middle. Oh. Nick is the youngest. Lisa, go again.
Boy bands for 2,000, please.
The K-pop group BTS says this is the English meaning of its name. Yeah, I didn't think anybody would get this one. What is beyond the scene?
No kidding.
I have no idea what it means.
Beyond the scene. Justin Timberlake is in a meme. Okay, I'm gonna stop.
All right, Lisa, we got new categories to get to choose from.
First from 400, please.
A collection, you said?
No, movie stars for 400.
Okay. Jane Smith, Lara Croft, and Maleficent are roles played by this actress. Sheldon.
Who's Jolie?
Angelina Jolie, correct.
Movie stars 2000.
Ooh, interesting. Tim Burton movies starring this actress include Sweeney Todd and Alice in Wonderland. Sheldon.
It was Helena Bonham Carter.
Correct.
16 movie stars.
He has played Magneto, Carl Jung, and Steve Jobs. Sheldon.
Who is Michael Fassbender?
Right.
12 movie stars.
Answer. Daily double. Got a commanding lead of 11,000. How much of that would you want to risk?
4,000, please.
Okay, 4,000 for this clue. Best of luck. His film roles include Whitey Bulger and Donnie Brasco.
Who is Depp?
Johnny Depp, you are correct. Taking you up to 15,000. Select again.
Let's finish off movie stars, please.
In 2010, Ancestry.com discovered this Twilight star is appropriately related to Vlad III, a.k.a. Dracula. Sheldon.
Who is Pattinson?
And you run the category.
Oh, okay. V is for Veterans Four.
This New England state's Office of Veterans Affairs is located in its capital, Montpelier. Lisa.
What is Vermont?
Correct.
V is for veterans for 800.
Iraq war vet Tony Craden attended the 2019 Super Bowl with support from Kirk Cousins of this Minnesota team. Lisa.
The Vikings.
Correct.
V is for veterans for 1200.
Before he was a wrestler and politician, he was a Navy man born James Janos. Chris.
Who is Jesse Ventura?
Indeed.
16 veterans.
VA health covers routine eye exams under this six-letter category of benefits. Chris.
What is optical?
No. Simple. Vision.
Oh, I
figured to guess myself.
I forgot the categories. 2000. Vision.
A VRC, this kind of rehabilitation counselor, provides employment services and training to eligible veterans. Sheldon.
What is it, vocational?
Vocational is right.
Holiday hints 12.
At Christmas, kiss your cat under this plant. Please forgive me for trying to pronounce this. Ferandendron leucarpum. But don't let her eat the white berries. Chris.
What is mistletoe?
Correct. Now, before we go on, real QVC, I understand you want to play along. But one of the rules is you cannot give out answers in the chat. So I'm just going to delete those messages real quick. That's no big deal. Just want to make sure our contestants are playing fair in case, you know, they're checking the stream as well. Chris, let's go again.
1600 holiday hints.
Answer is. Keep your dog calm during 4th of July fireworks with this shirt with a weather-related name. Sheldon.
What's a thunder shirt?
Correct.
Holiday 2000.
A good alternative to champagne on Valentine's is this sparkling apple cider made in Watsonville, California. Chris.
What is Martinelli's apple cider?
Yeah. Delicious.
Ooh. let's go ages for 400.
Also an Olympic medal, this historic age happened between the Stone and Iron Ages. Sheldon.
What is the Bronze Age?
Correct.
Holiday Hints 8.
Leave the core attached to the cob to hold on to Mexican street corn on this holiday observed on May 5th. Sheldon, excuse me.
What is Cinco de Mayo?
Yes.
400 holiday.
A handmade card and a Mamma Mia marathon are perfect for this holiday, the second Sunday in May. Lisa.
What is Mother's Day?
Yes.
Ages for 800.
In Kansas, the minimum age to start the process of getting this license is age 14. Lisa.
What is the driver's license?
Yes.
1,200 ages, please.
Optimus and Pals were in a flick 3 years later, so they must have survived this title age of their 2014 movie. Sheldon.
What is the age of extinction?
Yes.
16 ages.
Oh, boy. I found it. You have basically locked this game. How much of that 21,800 do you want to risk?
Ooh, I'm very worried about this. They're
telling you in the chat to go big.
Dev, I'm not doing it. let's. But what I will do is I'll go 11,800.
11,800. Here's the clue. The cold town of Ages is in Harlan County in the southeast part of this state.
Oh, good lord. No, I'm not going to get it. What is Indiana?
No, we were looking for...
Is it Kentucky?
Yeah, it was Kentucky.
I just thought of it.
But the good thing is you didn't lose everything.
See, I'm glad I didn't go for it.
Yeah, thanks, Dev. Okay.
Yeah.
Sheldon, still your turn.
All that pressure on me threw me off. Ages 2.
Since 1984, it's been the age at which you can become a full member of the AARP. Yeah, I already
taken one class. Lisa.
What is 55? No.
Dang it.
Chris.
What is 50?
50. That's right. Okay, you've now taken the lead.
Well, there's only one category left. Let's get it started. Collection 400.
You're not a loony just because you collect loonies, shekels, and other types of these. Sheldon?
Or coins.
Or currencies, right.
800 collection.
Some fishing enthusiasts collect these devices that let out the line on the rod. Chris.
What are lures?
No. Sheldon.
What are reels?
Reels, right.
12 collection.
A collection of these creatures mounted on pins may be hair streaks and swallowtails. Chris.
What are butterflies?
Right.
16.
A deltaologist is someone who collects these objects. Wish you were here. Sheldon.
What are postcards?
Right, and the last clue. Known as Action Number One, one of these collectibles was sold in 2014 for $3.2 million. Ooh, it was very close. Sheldon.
It's a comic book.
Or Superman, that's right. Well... Interesting scores as we go to Final Jeopardy. Sheldon has the lead with 14,800. Chris, not too far behind with 10,800. Lisa, you're still kind of the underdog in this, so who knows what could happen with this Final Jeopardy category. It is technology. Players, make your wagers. And while you do so, we're going to take our last commercial break. So please, check this out.
Can I get the now, please?
COVID-19 has changed how we stomp the yard and feel the beat.
Can I get the now bar, please?
$1.
Have a good one.
Got it.
Hey, what's going on?
Hey.
Let me get a now bar.
Sure. $1.
Appreciate you.
Got it.
COVID-19 has changed how we express our faith and gather to worship. Now it's time to take the first step that lets us get back to spreading the word without spreading concern. Before we can safely come together, we need the facts. As COVID-19 vaccines become available, you may have questions.
Should I get it?
Is it safe?
Should I wait?
It's smart to question. Now, get the facts at getvaccineanswers.org so you can make an informed decision when vaccines are available to you.
All right, I'll just go.
Okay. So, technology is our Final Jeopardy category. And why don't we... First, let me play the sound so y'all can hear it. Thank you. And let's take a look at our clue. In 1996, there were about 5 billion of these. In 2007, PC World stopped selling them. Players, there's going to be a thing that pops up. Please phrase it in the form of a question because it won't automatically do it for you. 30 seconds. Good luck. Let's see some hands for the music. All right, players. Let's see how you guys did. We're going to start with Lisa first. You had 3,600 going into Final Jeopardy. Let's take out the clue. And you wrote down, what are magazines? That is not the right response, unfortunately. And how much are you wagering? All of it. So, yeah, all the way down to zero. All right, Chris, we're going to go over to you. You had 10,800, and you selected what are magazines as well. Yikes. How much did you wager? Because your wager actually disappeared.
2,800, I did.
2,800, yeah. That was your wager, and you did not. So you are down to 8,000. So now we go over to Sheldon, who was in the lead, and you wrote down, what are floppy disks? And that is the correct response.
And you wagered.
Oh, boy, you wagered everything. That's going to make you the big winner of the day, $29,600. You are a Jeopardy champion, and you are going to be coming back next week to play again. Now, remember, I want to make this clear. Shell Mom. Let's hear some Shell Moms in the chat.
Shell Mom.
Well, this is what's going to happen. If you happen to win five times, you will be retired, and you will go home with a $50 Amazon gift card. So, that's the incentive to keep playing and keep playing well. So, everybody, I want to thank everybody for coming today and checking out this stream. You know, this was something I tried so hard to work on. You know, let me put my camera on so y'all can see my beautiful face. You know, I've been working on this for a long time, and I want to thank Sheldon, Lisa, and Chris for being the first players for today's show. So, Tuesday, June 8th, same time, same channel. We will be doing this again. And I hope to see you all then when Sheldon takes on two new players. Thanks a lot, everybody. Goodbye. And ladies and gentlemen, if you haven't done so already, please follow us on twitch.tv/TheJeffSquad. Also, follow us on Twitter @TheJeffSquad. You can also find our Discord server where you can... Hey, Cappers, thanks for the follow. Thank you. If you would like to be a contestant on Jeff Squad, there is a submission form in our Discord server. Please check it out under contestant applications. We'll see you guys next week. Until then, enjoy the rest of the credits.